Good morning, everybody. This is Van Hargis with Van Hargis Horsemanship. I appreciate you guys joining me for our little short trip over to the ranch. And again, we call this section the Ranch Road for obvious reasons. Today, we're going to talk about ignorance. And I don't always mean that in a negative way. In fact, most of the time, I don't mean it in a negative way. Because we can't help our ignorance unless we choose to be ignorant. And I got kind of tickled because yesterday or a couple of days ago, I don't remember when it was, but we were doing a little bit of bragging on one of our students. You see, each session that we have with our Horsemanship Academy, with each session, we have our students start cults, okay? So everybody has a cult to start and do something in their cult starting thing. Well, the other day, one of our students was kind of tested. And the test usually is that if they do everything that I instruct them to do, then by the end of that cult's first 60 days or so, I like to see if I can get on that cult and ride it around without pulling on its face. In other words, I want to see if the cult's truly that light and that responsive to our body position and our posture and, of course, our leg aids, and not dependent at all on the horse's face. Well, we posted a little video about the achievement of one of our students with a colt that had been in training for just under, he was just under 7 weeks. In fact, he was here for 8 weeks, but he had a little injury due to a mishap that cost him a little over a week in training, a little bit of time for him to recuperate. But nonetheless, we posted that video, and I couldn't be more proud of both my student as well as the colt, because I was literally loping it around with nothing around its neck other than just a little string around its neck. And I asked it to transition downward. The transition downward was a little bit bigger than what I'd wanted. And then we asked for a transition back up into a canter, and of course, changing leads in the process. So just a little simple lead change with nothing on the horse's face, and just to see if it would guide around in the circles at a canter, transition downward to the canter, and then pick up the proper lead back into the canter. And it did exceptionally well. And that was just one test. That was just all we could post on Facebook at the time. But here comes the ignorance, right? We had one lady in particular that just absolutely threw a shoe because we were loping a two-year-old. And I understand sometimes people think that starting two-year-olds under saddle is too early. I don't know what their argument is behind that. But I do ask them sometimes, so what is your argument for not starting two-year-olds under saddle? And every time I've ever heard them say that, they said, well, their growth plates aren't fully developed yet, and we don't want to injure our horses. And I've listened to that for years, and every time I happen to be around a veterinarian, and I happen to be around a veterinarian with a two-year-old in my hands, I will oftentimes ask the vet, so what do you think about riding two-year-olds and perhaps even loping two-year-olds? Have you ever run across any injury issues with growth plates? And I can't remember a single one that's ever said yes to that question. They've never once said, oh yeah, don't do it. It really causes bad damage. In fact, in all of my 40 plus years now as a horseman, the only injuries I've seen related to riding and pressing horses really hard has got a lot more to do with their stifles and their hocks than ever had to do with their growth plates and their knees. So I appreciate people having that argument that they think it's too young to start a horse under saddle, but don't give me some sort of BS excuse as to it's going to hurt their growth plates or whatever else. Again, I've made my entire career almost on starting colts under saddle. And in fact, I can't tell you how many reining and cutting fraternity babies that I've started for folks. And I've never once, not once, out of literally thousands, and I mean thousands, boy, I'm getting old, but literally thousands of colts that we've started, I've not had a single one ever that had issues with their growth plates. So I appreciate the comment, I really do. But let's think and do a little research before we start throwing stuff like that out there. So I don't want to sound like I'm dogging that particular person, and I'm not going to mention names by any stretch of imagination. However, I do want the industry to be thinking a little bit more logically on certain things, and that just happens to be one of them. If you're going to have an argument for not starting a two-year-old under saddle, please let it be in a legitimate argument, not something that has yet to be proven. So that's what I mean by addressing the idea of ignorance. So anyway, I appreciate you guys joining me as always on the Ranch Road. And until next time, this is Van Hargis with Van Hargis Horsemanship.